Chloe? What? Where? It's a dark room.
Is anybody out there? Please help!
Shit, that's me. He took that shot last night. Finally, I'm free. Almost. I hate looking at myself like that. You'll pay for this, Jefferson. I promised I would never go back in time like this again. But this is the only way.
This angle highlights your purity, see? The slightly unconscious model is often the most open and honest. No vanity or posing, just pure expression. Oh, Christ. Look at that perfect face. Hold that stare there! Stay still! Max! You fucked up my shot! But please don't worry. We have all the time in the world. For now, I knew you were special the second I saw your first selfie. Yes, I still hate that word. But I love the purity of your own image. Not like Rachel, who was always looking in the wrong places. Poor Rachel. Let me try this angle. Don't move! Oh. Much better. Thanks, Max. If only Nathan could see this setup. He tried so hard. But you can't just throw a few subjects around and expect a cohesive style or theme. But he had an eye for shadows, and an eye for a whole lot more, as his elite family will find out, along with Arcadia Bay. Nice. Oh, good. Oh, those eyes. It's just too bad you're so goddamn nosy, Max. But this room is under 24/7 surveillance, so all I had to do was text you from Nathan's phone, and you fell right into my hands. You really should have focused on schoolwork, not private detecting with your little friend.
Chloe.
Chloe, right. Yeah, I'm sorry that I killed... that Nathan killed her in self-defense. But she had a troubled history, like most Arcadia Bay dropouts. Nobody will be surprised. Or care. Though I promise, people will care when you die tonight, Max. I wasn't lying when I said you have a gift. Okay. Now this looks good. Maybe a few more close-ups. Max, please do not move so much. I need you posed and framed my way.
Maybe a new dose will calm you down.
No.
Now don't move or this will hurt much. Stupid bitch! You just don't listen, do you? In fact, you never did hear much in my class. If you had, you might have seen all this coming. God damn, you are a fighter, though. I've had my eye on you, and I've noticed that you've been more fearless this week than maybe your whole life.
No.
Remember my number one rule. Always take the shot.
I'd really like to smash that fancy camera into Jefferson's face. Whoa! I'm definitely more awake in this photo. I could try this one. Okay, I broke those vials when I kicked the trolley. This might work. Please work.
I'm getting some spectacular images here, Max. Yes, Victoria would kill to be in your place, but she doesn't understand our connection. You're the winner, Max. I choose you, your portrait.
Fuck you.
You're trying too hard. I know you're scared. You all have the same doe-eyed look when you wake up here, replaced by fear as you realize what's about to happen.
Mr. Jefferson, why are you doing this?
Oh, Max, I'm so glad you asked that question. Simply put, I'm obsessed with the idea of capturing that moment innocence evolves into corruption. That shift from black to white to gray and beyond. Most models are cynical. They lose that naivete. However, some Blackwell students carry their hope and optimism with them like an aura, and those lucky few become my models, my subjects.
Yes, you're a psychopath, and this is your last session.
Au contraire, Max. I'm so sane that nobody knows what's happening to you right now. And don't get me started on your late partner. I had enough of those faux punk sluts in my Seattle days.
Go to hell. You will for everybody you've hurt.
Unlike pure sweet Kate Marsh, I don't believe in that bullshit. She could have been my masterpiece. The world is what an artist makes it. And my muse...
blah, blah, blah. God, I hate your voice now.
You might as well savor it, considering it's the last you'll hear. Oh. That struck a nerve. Your face changed color. Beautiful.
You will not get away with this. I want you to know that.
Too bad you already made a convincing argument against Nathan in the principal's office. Thank you so much for setting him up for me. I do know that the Prescotts are going to have a major scandal when the town finds out what their elite son has been doing for homework.
You used Nathan.
I prefer the term manipulated. Like with an image. Nathan's was easy to twist around. I became a sort of father figure for Nathan. It happens often in teacher-student relationships. It was kind of touching for a while.
Did you tell him everything about your plans at Blackwell?
Don't be stupid, Max. I told him what he needed to hear. In return, I had access to the Prescott fortune. Who do you think paid for this glorious darkroom and equipment? How else could I get all these hip new drugs for my subjects?
Rachel Amber was your victim, not your subject.
Oh. Rachel Amber. That's the real tragedy. Nathan thought he could be an artist like me. Instead, the dumbass gave her an overdose.
Chloe and Rachel. You killed both of them.
They're fucking together in heaven right now. Is that what you want to hear?
Why? Why?
Why? Why? Start listening to me, you dumb cunt. I'm sorry, Max. That was not cool. Anyway, Rachel is dead. But no tears. Los Angeles would have killed her anyway, so look at this as a favor.
You're evil.
Oh, I see. You're good, because you stopped your friend from beating Nathan up.
I cared more about Nathan than you did.
No, you didn't. It's just too bad that he fell in lust with Rachel. He actually thought he could mimic what I do with the camera and subject, like father, but not like son.
Where is Nathan now?
Dead and buried. After what he did to Rachel, I knew I couldn't keep him as a protege for much longer. Now the police will never find his body. Do you finally get it now, Max? I can't compromise my vision with amateurs.
You are an amateur. Look at the trail of death you left behind. You can't blame all this on Nathan. I don't care what you do to me. You're gonna die, motherfucker. For Chloe and Rachel and everybody else.
I do love your spirit, Max, but you brought yourself here by your own choice. Anyway, I like my models to be seen and not heard. So I have to make sure there's nothing left behind of you. Okay. Now, let's see how these shots came out. I can see why your instant camera is so appealing. You don't need a computer to print your workout.
Alone with a heart, a battered old heart, a heart.
I have all those photos in my diary. This could be a way out.
This is purity personified. Okay. Now, let's see how.
Wait! Please, Mr. Jefferson.
Max, I would love to talk shop, but I really need to go over these pictures. Especially while they're fresh in my mind. I think our session was a career high for me.
You still have my diary.
Don't worry. Nobody's going to read it. Thanks for reminding me. There's nothing more innocent than a teenager's diary. Oh, look at your selfies. What a waste of talent. Look at that shot, Max. You can do so much better.
Alone with a heart, a battered old heart.
I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word
for a wonderful photographic tradition. Right back where I started this insane week. And nobody is going to hurt Chloe ever again.
A portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
The Daguerrean process.
Oh. Well, that was easy, Max.
Was it? Okay.
Well, okay then. So, the Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Obviously, Max has read them. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday
time
Heroes.
To change time.
The winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the
first. Let's make it real easy to capture Mark Jefferson.
And Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Bastard. I have to warn David about Jefferson and the dark room. I should be able to track down David's number from the school pamphlet. Found you.
I just worked so hard on the shot, and I'm sure you know what it's like to be consumed by your work. I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event.
For once, David, I'm praying you'll overreact to this as much as everything else. And take Jefferson down fast. You wanted me to enter the contest, asshole. So maybe I'll be going to San Francisco. And Jefferson, you'll be going to prison. The past within the past. Am I pushing myself too hard? This fancy camera does not give you any extra talent, Victoria. Or excuses. You will not hurt Kate Marsh this time. Mr. Jefferson, we need to talk.
Can you see I'm talking to Mr. Jefferson now?
I can see you're kissing ass again. Nothing new.
What did you just say?
Hold on, Victoria. Are you okay, Max?
Not until Victoria knows that hiding behind a screen and posting videos of people is totally fucked up. You know how easy it is to hurt somebody? To destroy their life? Are you proud of yourself? If you have any feelings left, you should think about your actions.
Listen, I didn't...
Of course you did. You're so insecure, you can't even be happy with your own talent. You have to try and bring everybody down to your mean and ugly level.
Okay, I do not have to listen to this bullshit. Do I, Mr. Jefferson?
Well, it looks like you already did, Victoria.
Then I guess I'm done talking.
I sure hope so.
I'm not going to say I didn't enjoy that, but why?
Here's my photograph for the Everyday Heroes contest.
Oh, that was easy.
No, it wasn't easy at all.
Well, I can't prejudge yet, but I'm very happy you decided to enter. That means a lot to me. And Blackwell, the first step for any artist is to put themselves out there in the world without fear. To be innocent.
Or guilty.
Well, and thanks for the photo, and maybe both of us will be jet-setting to San Francisco this Friday.
Or maybe only one of us will be going.
Don't be so modest, Max. Anything can happen in a week.
As you're going to find out, Mr. Jefferson. Okay. You're okay, Max. You're safe. On a plane. I hope I did everything right this time. Good work, David. To admit, I love being called an artist. We're almost in San Francisco. I'm so stressed, but I'm so excited too.
Wait to land in Frisco. Nobody calls it Frisco.
Aw, I haven't seen Hot Dog Man in forever. Chloe and I used to totally play the video game and watch him all the time. When we were innocent. It's so weird to be in between realities. Everything is out of focus and in the distance. It's the beginning of the end for Jefferson and the Prescotts.
Please fasten your seat and stow any electronic gear until the plane is on the ground and at the gate. Thank you. We're starting our descent in a few minutes. It's a beautiful day in San Francisco with clear skies and cool 60 degrees. We hope you enjoyed your trip and we thank you very much for choosing Pacific West Air. Come fly with us anytime.
Oh, I don't think so. I'm hoping these airline seats get smaller so I won't have to fly at all anymore.
How did you sleep?
Hope I wasn't snoring out loud, Max.
Just a bit.
It's been a tough week at Blackwell. So I hope you'll forgive me. Between Mr. Jefferson and Prescott's, things have been hectic, to say the least.
I totally get it, Principal Wells.
That's a smart way of telling me to stop whining. We are proud of you for representing Blackwell at the Everyday Heroes Contest. I know I'm not exactly the guy you wanted in San Francisco, but we all want you to have a great experience here.
I already am, and we're not even there. Oh, Christ. Another nosebleed? Max, you're not just screwing around with time. San Francisco is so cool. And this gallery is huge.
So is the buffet. If an event skimps on the food, you know it's a bad event.
As long as I don't have to eat any caviar.
This is your day, Max. You can do whatever you want. I hope you take advantage of your status and talk to as many influential people here as possible. Work the room.
I don't know. I feel so weird, like I'm a little kid hanging with the adults.
Max. After this week, you are certainly not a little kid anymore. In fact, you're a noteworthy adult being honored by your peers. Now you have to start acting like the photographer you want to be. Hell, I wanted to be in charge of a big school someday. So I started taking charge of things when I was young. Ask my poor classmates. Max, I'm going to eat up that caviar so you don't have to. Better get in there and start schmoozing. You know, I won't always be here to take charge. But you come talk to me whenever you want.
Come on, Max. After everything that's happened, this should be the least scary thing you've ever done. Wowzer, Max. You did it. There I am, along with all the other winners. I should say, artists instead. The Zeitgeist Gallery does have a cool history in Frisco. San Francisco.
Why, good morning. You must be Max Caulfield. Congratulations for your Everyday Heroes photo. The exhibition is quite impressive, especially with your entry.
I heard Mark Jefferson was supposed to be here tonight.
Not anymore.
That was so shocking. I have one of his monographs, too.
Hold on to it. His work is going to be worth serious cash.
Are you Max Caulfield? Bravo on your entry. I'm the art critic for Iris N magazine, and we would love to include you in a piece about future trendsetters in photography. I'll send you the details this week, if that's okay. Congratulations for your piece.
How do these galleries afford to rent here?
I wonder if I can buy these Everyday Heroes pictures. Sorry, I don't know your name, but I saw your picture in the gallery brochure, and I just wanted to let you know how cool your entry was.
God, I love art. You must be the Everyday Hero from Blackwell. My name is Lauren Francis, and I run the media department at Detroit School of Visual Arts. I'd love to talk about you being a residency next spring. Don't say anything to Principal Wells yet.
Like I was back in high school.
That is different.
Usually these kind of contests, they put me to sleep.
I always
like how
get so inspired whenever
actions,
I come
you know, not just abstractions. The zeitgeist
bad
is still
exposure, bad framing, here bad on the plaque.
Max
I could have done this
every
so
day
much
hero.
Better.
I can't believe I'm in San Francisco. How can I process this after all the death I've seen this week? I wish Chloe was here with me now. Without her, I couldn't have fought Jefferson. And she always pushed me to not be shy about my photos. Even if that feels so trivial after what happened with Rachel and Kate. But for whatever reason, I have this power. I hope I finally used it right.
And there she is to save the day.
Hi. You did it, Max. You're a real artist. At least for today.
Are you okay? We lost you there for a second.
Your nose.
I'm okay. Jet lag. High altitude. Oh, you left the ringer off, idiot. Oh, come on. Please answer.
Max, holy shit, man, your vision. It's true. You saw the tornado, it's coming.
What? Oh, no. Chloe, where are you?
I'm so fucking scared! I'm by the beach!
Chloe! Can you hear me? Hello? Hello? Oh my god! The tornado was real! I didn't fix shit! Chloe will die. Arcadia Bay is gonna be destroyed. There has to be a way to stop this. For good.
Look at this print. The depth of field, the colors. Look at the bokeh shape. This was definitely shot with a medium format camera using a Leica 35mm lens. You can
No fucking way. Chloe can't die again. I have to save her.
How much would you pay for that?
How do these galleries afford to rent here? I know it's kind of simple, but I find this haunting.
Right? The instant printmaking.
Please, no. I have to be in Arcadia Bay to help Chloe. Not here.
I heard Mark Jefferson was supposed to be here tonight.
Not anymore.
That was so...
This makes me feel so
bad
sad.
Bad exposure.
Like I was back in high
school. Bad framing. Bad picture.
Excuse me, I'd love to ask you a few questions about your work.
Sorry, but... Now, it feels like reality is breaking apart. What am I doing to time? I just have to make one simple change so I won't end up in San Francisco. Simple. Sorry, San Francisco. Chloe comes first. Here again? I thought I fixed everything.
What did you say, Max?
What? Jefferson should be in jail, not here.
Jesus. It's like you're back in my class. You're still spacing out. It might be cool if you took one of your patented selfies now. The transformation between the old Max and the new Max. Anyway, answer my question, please.
Fuck you.
Good answer. Good answer. Hey, your nose is bleeding. Probably gave you too big a dose. Sorry about that, Max. But considering you're about to die, a nosebleed is a first world problem. Your iris, that dilation like a shutter. The pictures you're taking of me now. Too bad you pissed away your gift. You could have won the contest, but you destroyed your own beautiful photograph. What a waste. Sorry, I burned all your stuff. I got a little carried away.
Fuck! He burned my diary.
Always.
That's why I'm still here.
Especially since you've developed from nerd to hero within a week. There's something weird going on with you. Whoa. Did you see how crazy it is outside? Like I said, something weird. There's that fear. Oh, Max, it's an honor working with you on these final sessions. I hope these images will be appreciated for what they truly capture. The loss of youth. At least, that's the last lecture you'll ever have to hear from me. And I promise you, no more nosebleeds.
Mr. Jefferson, please, don't do this. You don't know what's happening.
Shh, 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 shh. Quiet. quiet, Max.
Please, don't do this.
I promise, this final dose won't hurt. No more nosebleeds.
Wait, hold on. Can I please ask you for one last request?
Oh, you got me, Max. How can I deny that face?
Could you please at least play some music so I can drift away?
Even at the end, you're still a dreamer, Max. It's a nice trait.
Now I'm a little bit crazy. Out of my mind, I'm going slightly straight to the head. It's all a little bit hazy. But I'm pretty sure I'm gonna stay screwy instead. And I'm a little.
What?
And would you mind turning off the lights? They make me squint, so I won't look good for the shot.
Now, you're thinking like a real photographer. And I don't want your last memory to be bad lighting. I promise, this final dose won't hurt.
You know that!
And I promise.
And will you...
And I prom...
Excuse me, but my throat is scratchy. Can I please have some water?
Of course. I don't want you to be uncomfortable. promise. This final dose won't hurt. What?
David, watch out!
How? How did you know that? No gun. No balls.
Jefferson, it's over.
You are not going to stop me. David Mattson. Of course. Well, this is what you...
Jefferson, it's over.
He's hiding a gun over there.
Sorry, Mattson. Okay. You're not going to stop me.
Jefferson, it's over.
Grab that bottle.
Not going to stop me.
Grab that bottle.
David Matt.
Jefferson, it's over.
You are not going to stop me. What going to stop me?
Grab that bottle.
Jefferson, it's over.
You are not going to stop me.
Jefferson, it's over.
Grab your gun now.
Got it. Oh, Christ. David Mattson, you are one stupid son of a bitch.
Jefferson, it's over.
You are not going to stop me.
Jefferson, it's over.
Oh, Lord, Max. Are you okay? Are you all right? Can you move?
Yes. Thank you, David. Thank you.
Don't thank me. You brought me here. Let's wrap up this son of a bitch first. He won't be going anywhere when he wakes up. Except you are going to prison forever. Or worse.
Mr. Jefferson, now it's your turn to be captured in a moment. Save Chloe.
He burned everything, including all of my photos.
Warren! Yes! I can use that picture he took of us. No signal. Thanks, Mr. Jefferson, but you won't need this anymore.
The Prescotts had to know about this.
I better go outside and call Warren.
David?
Are you okay?
Look at this place. It feels like hell.
Jefferson was going to kill me. You got here just in time.
I'm glad. I always suspected that son of a bitch.
I never did. Until too late.
You shouldn't have to suspect your teacher.
He wasn't a real teacher. He just wanted to lecture. It was part of his sick plans.
I wasn't surprised when you accused Nathan of drugging Kate Marsh. I thought so too. And Max, I'll never forgive myself for what happened to Kate. I feel like I helped push her off that roof.
Kate was bullied up to that roof, but it was still Nathan and Jefferson who put her there.
I knew Nathan Prescott was a threat. I just waited too long to neutralize him.
Jefferson already did. They had some weird father-son thing going on. But Nathan killed Rachel, and Jefferson had to use him as a scapegoat.
That pervert was pulling all this shit right under my nose, too. I could have stopped him and Nathan if only... I wasn't so stupid.
No, I should have told Principal Wells Nathan had a gun and almost used it. I put the school in danger.
We all make decisions we regret. But I have to admit, I'm impressed by you. And Chloe. And your investigation. I had all the high-tech toys while you had each other.
We are a great team.
That's one of my problems. I'm not good at teamwork. Never was. Even in the service.
I can't even imagine what you went through.
I'm not gonna make any excuses for my behavior. I tried to be a good soldier, but I wasn't so great. I tried to be a good father, too, but when Joyce kicked me out, I had nothing.
I was pissed off and wanted to rage.
Yeah. I know the feeling. Too much.
I'm going to tell Joyce I was wrong about you. She does love you. It's pretty obvious.
I try not to use my service as an excuse, but it's hard to come home after war. Most people don't know or care what it's like. Except Joyce. She gave me hope. A new life.
And you saved mine. Chloe, she would be proud of you.
I just want to see her safe with her mother. I promised Joyce I would go see a family counselor. I'll start by apologizing to Chloe. I don't expect her to call me Dad, but maybe she'll stop calling me Step Douche. So, where is Chloe?
David, she was pretty stressed out, so she went to go medicate before I ended up in here. So she's okay.
Oh, thank God. For once, I'm happy Chloe's a stoner.
David, I have to go outside and get some real air and use my phone.
Of course. Go on, Max. You're a brave soldier. I'm glad Chloe has a best friend like you. Go on now. You've seen enough of this room.
Okay, teacher. Let's see what kind of photo evidence you shit all over this computer.
I could have told David the truth. He deserves it.
How could you? How?
Freedom. Holy shit. This storm is real. I need to find Warren. Yes! Warren, can you hear me? Never mind. Listen, do you have that photo you took last night in the parking lot?
Yeah, but why? It wasn't that great a shot.
Yes, it is, and I want it. Where are you?
I'm at the Two Wells Diner. Pretty much trapped in here with Joyce thanks to this Armageddon weather. I'm expecting the ocean to turn red.
I'm on my way.
Come on, that's crazy. I can barely walk on the sidewalk outside. Seriously, Max, stay wherever you are. I don't think the storm's getting smaller. scared.
That's okay. Me too. But it's not over yet, Warren. So hold on.
Culture of sin and entitlement would lead to God striking us down. And I'm the one trapped in this fucking radio station. Somebody get me the hell out of here now! Now, goddammit, how I pay all those taxes!
You have one new message. Message received yesterday at 9 p.m.
Max, it's Nathan. I just wanted to say, I'm sorry. I didn't want to hurt Kate or Rachel or I didn't want to hurt anybody. Everybody used me. Mr. Jefferson is coming for me now. All this shit will be over soon. Watch out, Max. He wants to hurt you next. Sorry.
How can I get out of here? If we can make it out of this, Chloe. This makes me so sad. Damn. Okay. I just need to switch on the electricity to activate the sprinkler. Dead. Electrocuted. I want to help that fisherman, but he's in shock and he might not hear me. we can make it out of this, Chloe. I want to help that fisherman, but he's in shock and he might not hear me. Out of here right now.
I need to breathe. I need Eric. This can't be the end.
Okay, I better hurry to the diner over there. I need Warren's photo.
To go there now. Off. Now I have to find another way into the diner. Look at that. This tornado might be the end of the world, but not if I can change it. At least nobody's going to starve in here.
Tornado warning has been issued for Arcadia Bay and surrounding counties. The emergency broadcast system is now in effect.
Max! Oh, Max! Oh,
Jesus, I am so glad to see you, sweetie. Are you okay?
Yes. What about you guys?
Two Whales is barely standing now. I don't know if it's gonna make it through this tornado. Oh, poor Officer Barry and all those people out there.
I know.
Okay, get your ass inside. I have to get back to this gentleman on the ground. Lauren has been gathering all the first aid.
It's not much, Joyce, but it's all we have.
You okay, Warren?
How the hell did I ignore all those warnings, Max? The snow? The eclipse?
There's nothing you could do about it, Warren.
I'm so stupid. Should have seen it coming.
So glad everybody is safe here. But I need that photo from Warren to help.
I hate to say I'm glad to see you, but I'm so glad to see you.
That's okay. The important thing is that you're safe. And I know you can take care of yourself after Nathan.
Should have done that a long time ago. But damn, Max. Can't believe you actually drove down here in the middle of a fucking E6 tornado. Just for one photograph? I mean, I know you didn't come for me.
Warren, I came for all of you. Just tell me you do have the photograph.
I just want...
Now shut up and listen.
Oh yeah. You're finally going to tell me what you never did in the parking lot.
I wish I would have. So I'm just going to tell you without any explanation. Trust me, okay?
I always do. You should probably tell me quick.
I had a vision in Jefferson's class of a tornado destroying Arcadia Bay. I went to the bathroom and saw my best friend Chloe get shot by Nathan Prescott. You with me so far?
Where else could I be? Go on.
Then I found out that I could rewind time. And long story short, Mark Jefferson is insane and dangerous.
Whoa! Is that all?
I have to go back in time. Jefferson already killed Chloe. I can't let that happen. I have to do something, Warren.
Max, going back in time is what caused the storm.
All because of me? How?
I'm not a real scientist, even though I play one at school, but this seems like pure cause and effect. Maybe chaos theory. What happened with Jefferson? Did he hurt you?
Nathan accidentally killed Rachel Amber trying to impress Jefferson. Nathan just needed mental help. Now he's dead, and Jefferson is done.
Jesus, Max! I want the whole story, but I guess we really are out of time.
But I can still change things. What do you think will happen?
For every action, there's a reaction. Whenever you reversed or altered time, maybe you caused a chain reaction. Even in the environment.
All this destruction is my fault.
Give me a break. You sure the hell didn't give yourself time travel powers.
I guess we'll never know if it's magic or science.
Even if it's from a wizard or a wormhole, you're part of something bigger. I don't believe in fate or destiny, but after this week, I realize I don't know shit.
That makes both of us, Warren.
I do know you're here for a reason. And I guess it's up to you to find out why. Max, I'm sorry you got stuck in this. I don't have a fucking clue what's going on. But I have total faith that you'll do the right thing when the time comes. I'm so proud of you, Max. How could there be a more important moment in history? And I'm in the middle of it with you. So thank you for trusting me.
Thanks for being here. Always.
I can't seem to escape the two Whales.
Hey. Be careful out there.
For luck.
Just in case we don't get out of this, I wanted to say...
I know, Warren.
Of course you do.
I'm going to make the right choices from now on. I swear.
That's why you're Super Max.
For this shit. Come on, Max. Chloe! Jesus, dude, what is up with you?
I'm just glad we're here together.
I guess you need to talk. No worries. It's all good.
I'm glad you're with me, too. What's going on, Max? We have to find Nathan right now. He's gonna
Sorry, Warren.
Connected to Rachel. Let's go. Now. Chloe, wait! Listen! I can walk and listen, okay? Stop and listen for once! Fine, Max. I'm listening.
Chloe, you can't go in that party. You're gonna die if you do.
You used your powers, right? And you fucked around with time and I died.
Not like that.
You're supposed to back me up. So there's no way that punk-ass bitch Nathan Prescott is taking me down.
You're right, he won't. Mark Jefferson killed you. And others.
Jefferson, the art teacher? That's bullshit! Nathan is the fucking serial killer! We saw the proof! Now excuse me, I'm going to that party to make sure he never hurts anybody again. Are you coming?
Nathan is dead, and you're in danger.
That fucker is already dead? How do you know that?
Because I was there.
Will you please tell me exactly what happened? Please.
Chloe... Jefferson drugged and kidnapped me. I was tied up in his bunker. You have no idea what hell I went through to get back here. But I couldn't let you die. You brought me back here, and I can't lose you again. I won't.
Max, I'm so sorry. I was the one who dragged you into all this shit. Nobody, especially you, should have to go through that. Now we have to stop Jefferson. With one bullet.
No, not this way. Chloe, I can't keep fixing everything if all I'm gonna do is just break it over and over again. I know how this is gonna turn out, and I'm afraid I'm fucking up all these alternate realities.
Wait, alternate realities? What do you mean, Max? What did you do?
I fucked up, Chloe. I wanted to make things right, but everything turned out wrong.
Max, what the hell are you talking about?
I was able to go back in time to the last day William was alive. I stopped him from leaving, but you ended up in a car crash instead.
You saw my dad again?
You were completely paralyzed. And... You were in pain. You were slowly dying, and you asked me to end your life. But Chloe, there was no way I could do that. I had to return to this timeline to see you again. I had to.
God, Max. That must have been awful for you. I'm so sorry I had to ask you that.
It was worse for you. But I had no idea what would happen, and as usual, I messed everything up, and... I never want to hurt you. Ever. You have to believe me.
Of course I do. Do you think I would even know how to handle that situation? Nobody would. The important thing is that we're together again.
You're right. That's why you should come with me, so we can stay together and stay alive.
I hear you, Max, but do you think we should let Jefferson get away with torture and murder? Of course not. If we tell David, he'll believe us and he can actually stop him. Right? I don't get it. Why do you trust him after you totally reamed him the other day? He's not even at our house anymore. Chloe, David saved me from Jefferson. If he didn't track down the darkroom, I'd be dead right now. Max, I had no clue. I should have been the one to save you, but I'm so grateful David was there. So what's your plan? We tell him everything, including that Victoria is in danger. Okay. You've been through so much. I believe you, Max. After all, I'm still your faithful companion. Yes, you are. So listen, in a few minutes, I won't know any of this happened. Nothing. We absolutely have to stay in your room and do nothing. Then we explain everything to David, and we finally let him do his job. You'll have to tell me exactly what I did and said just now. Just explain that I traveled through time using the photo.
Will you believe me?
I'll always believe you, Chloe.
Dude.
Shut up. Oh, you're alive. You're alive. Oh, both of us. I did so much to bring you back, Chloe. It worked. Actually worked. You're with me again.
Looks like even fate doesn't want us apart. And I traveled through multiple realities just to save my ungrateful ass over and over. And I hope it was worth it. But I don't blame you for wanting me out of your life after all my drama.
Come on. I'm the official drama king and queen of Arcadia Bay this week. Just look at what my powers have caused in just a short time. Nobody.
You're Max fucking Caulfield, Time Warrior. Even if you weren't, you're kind and caring. Nobody could have a better best friend. Nobody. You didn't ask for any of this to happen, but it did. You need to accept how awesome you are.
Maybe I willed it subconsciously to myself. I always wanted my life to be special. An adventure. But not without you. And it didn't happen until I moved back here. So without you, my powers wouldn't even exist.
And for whatever scientific, mystical reason that we'll obviously never figure out, we were meant to be together. This exact moment in history. I have to think that Rachel was somewhere behind the scenes, fighting for justice.
I'd like to think that too. We all owe Rachel Amber. Now tell me everything that happened. You remember, right?
Well, we left the party and made sure Jefferson couldn't find us. For once, I was glad I lived in an actual fortress. Then the storm got hella crazy, and you said we would be safe at the lighthouse.
Chloe, look. The storm is getting bigger now. It's coming closer. Ugh, I can't even believe this is real. This is happening because of me.
Stop it. Just stop beating yourself up, okay? We both paid our dues already on it. God, look at that. Look at that monster. Who knows? This could be Rachel's revenge. Our revenge. The lighthouse is out of the way of the tornado. Come on!
Chloe,
I've got your back, Max.
Whoa.
Alfred Hitchcock famously called film "little pieces of time."
I'm back in class. Photography, as he likely what the calls. Hell?
These pieces of time can frame us in our glory and
I
our
have
sorrow.
To listen to this Jefferson light, lecture again. Shadow, this might color, be hell.
Now. Can you give me an example of a photographer
okay,
who perfectly captured the human
up.
Condition in black and white?
Am I stuck in a time loop?
Anybody? Bueller?
Diane Arbus.
Be calm and there you go, don't Gloria. Freak out.
Why Arbus?
Yet.
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's bullshit. Shh, 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 shh. Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation.
Everybody's gone now. Have I totally fucked up time? This doesn't make sense. Not yet, you bastard. I'm sorry, Kate. Oh, that's too creepy. I'm not going to take the bait. I'm not. Rachel didn't deserve any of this. Oh no.
I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I just wanted to know if you'd like to spend the rest of your life in my darkroom. Your purity inspires me so much, and we could be so happy together. Who needs selfies when I can give you portraiture?
There's no way I'm saying that. No way. It's about time somebody finally killed Chloe. Think of how often that bitch almost got me killed. It's like you're doing both of us an awesome favor.
Chloe can never appreciate you the way I will. Maxine. And yes, I insist on calling you Maxine. Forever.
This can't be real. I don't believe it.
Hey, Kate.
Max, how could you let me jump off a roof? You're the only person I trusted here, but you never really listened to me. Now I'm never going to heaven. Instead, you've stuck me in hell. Alone forever.
No! Kate, I was only trying to save you.
Thank you.
Never mind me, officer. I'm just here to steal a popular speech.
Ends. I better find something.
Drum roll, please. I present a spare piece of black hole. Thank you, Step Prick. Rachel Amber. She was my angel. After my dad died and he moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life. So Rachel took my place. I'm glad she was there for you. 6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she just disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her. Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
I think my entries for the contest might be too good.
Do you think it's like fate we're not supposed to be friends?
You might as well choose me. Otherwise, I might have to tell people you offered to choose my photo for favors. Did you think we were best friends forever or something?
Victoria's room has to be nearby.
Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a ton record on video.
Don't try to hide, Max! Get over here! Let me capture you!
Jefferson is coming after me again.
You used to be so pure, so innocent. Now, you have to die. Please understand, Max. The only place I can be myselfie is in the dark room. What
happened?
Max! You used to be so pure, so innocent. Now, you have to die.
Max!
Oh, Max!
Max.
Oh, Max!
Hey, Max. Max. Max?
Oh, Max! Max!
Good evening, Blackwell. This is Principal Wells, and I'm here to drop the mic on Max Caulfield. Attention! I regret to announce that one of your fellow classmates, Maxine Caulfield, has died under tragic circumstances that I promise to investigate after I get my drink on. Wait, Max. I get my drink on. Will Max Caulfield please come to...
Max, where are you? Max, come out to play. Come out to play. Hey, babe, babe. Who wants to go ape? Go ape, babe, babe. You dig my wheels, Max? Get in the car. I'll take you for a ride. Get in the car!
As well have pushed her ass off that roof.
Samuel wants to make sure Sam never snooped
had to mop up blood.
Max, I know you're in here. You can run, but you can't hide from your white knight.
Hold on, Max.
Hide from your white knight. Give it up!
How can I tell Max's parents that she's Miss Coffee? Max's parents that she's a nosy little bitch.
You didn't become friends with the Tabanga.
Hey, Max. Please, come here.
I knew I should have given that
so I can beat you up!
Stop! Right now!
Swallows your ass.
It's fucking ironic that I ended up being right about everything.
Get your bony ass over here. I'm gonna cut you open, freak.
Those were my beans, Max. Those were my fucking beans.
Max.
Oh no. Come back. Bottles. This might be
Max.
What she's talking about now.
Max. Max. Rachel got shot. She gave great head.
If you took some of my drugs,
especially after I dug her body in to be with her wife.
Max.
Posing for me in hell.
Well, these ones aren't too hard to find.
Just because I'm mentally ill, does it mean...
Max, sit down. You're taking a timeout, no matter what. If this is my nightmare, let me have one sanctuary. Of course, this is where Chloe and Rachel used to hide from the world. But I can't hide for long. Whatever reality I'm in feels like a bad dream. Am I just not learning my lesson? Maybe your real lesson is to get out of this place. Just don't be afraid, Max. Let them be afraid of you. Did I get bad bottle karma?
Me and Rachel are... Rax. Me and Rachel are floating down here in the sewer. Come on down.
Nobody ever helped me, Max.
Was there one more left?
It's gonna be so sweet when I bury your carcass next to Rachel.
Stop! Like there are still bottles to find. Oh, joy.
If you took some of Rachel looked just like a zombie model in the dirt.
Max.
Hey.
Max! Hey, Max!
Oh, Max!
Max? Max!
Please let that be the last one.
Oh, Max!
Max! Max!
Chloe, I blame you for this. You will pay. I need proof that bottles were out to get me, just in case.
Don't you dare question the chef.
Right, like you're the real cook here?
I am, when your mom's away.
I'll let her know that.
Hello? Hey, honey. Just making a fabulous breakfast with Chloe and Max. We're all going to work at the Two Winds. What? didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Now I'll have an excuse to get a mocha. Be there shortly. Love you. Excuse me, ladies. I have to go rescue yonder queen at the Save Mart. She doth have many bags of delicious grub for us
to
feast
upon. You are ridiculous.
You'll be grateful for that someday. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund? Keys, please. Shit, where are those keys?
Another dollar for the swear jar.
You're bankrupting me. Aha! You can't hide from me forever. Now lock up after I leave. Play nice. Try not to destroy too much of the house. And no Chloe and Max wine tasting. Session.
Dad!
How long will this nightmare go on?
I think you'd be perfect for my new photo series on retro grunge. You have the same qualities that I loved in Rachel Amber. But not Max.
Max is a fucking child.
Oh, Christ, I know. I think you'd be perfect for my new photo series on retro grunge. You have the same qualities that I loved in Rachel Amber. But not Max.
Max is a fucking child.
Oh, Christ, I know. And she never shuts up, does she?
I'm so over her hipster bullshit.
I think everyone at Blackwell is over Max. Let's prove it.
Booyah, Warren. I thought you were all over Max's shit.
Not after she kissed me. Her breath was ass and no tongue.
I hear that. I'm not into nerds, but you're pretty cute.
I'm not into Max anyway. So let's bust a move. God damn, you are a sexy bitch. Why hang out with Max, huh?
Boredom. Plus, she's like my personal puppet.
I hear that. Do you want a party? I got a drugstore in my room.
Oh shit, look at Max spying on us. Take a fucking picture, bitch. Or take a selfie. See, this is how you bust a move, Max. No mosh pit for you, shaka bra. Damn, Victoria. You're a real woman. Not a little girl like Max.
I fucking love your tats, Chloe. You're so hot. I can't believe it took us so long to hook up.
Why did you get rewind powers? You don't even know how to use them. Rachel's dead and you're still alive? Life is so not fair. I wish you would have never come back to Arcadia Bay. You're the real Storm. Great. Numbers are all over the place. How will I find the right code? Don't kill us, Max!
I guess I'll never dance again, Max.
Right when I was about to start a new life in California.
Shit, Max.
I can't believe you kissed me.
I thought we were on the same team.
Now you're going to
Honey,
kill me?
I've always thought of you like a daughter. And now you're gonna
so
take me
So this is how Max gets her revenge?
Shit, Max.
Why would you do that?
I thought we were on the same team.
So this is how Max
killing
gets her revenge?
I know
so
I haven't been the
my
best
husband
friends.
And new baby.
I
wish we had been friends. Please, Max, don't kill me.
Who are you? Holy shit, are you serial? I'm you, dumbass. Or I'm one of many Maxes you've left behind. Can you get me out of here? Oh, so you want help? Thought you could control everybody and everything, huh? Twist time around your fingers? I tried to help. I only wanted to do the right thing. No, you only wanted to be popular. And once you got these amazing powers, your big plan was to trick people into thinking you give a rat's ass. I do care. That's why I was trying to make friends. By telling people what they want to hear? You were just looking for a shortcut because you can't make friends on your own. That's not true. I have great friends, and I've used my powers for good. Please, stop playing innocent. You're a goddamn hypocrite. You've left a trail of death and suffering behind you. That was not my fault, you son of a bitch. Don't you dare talk about our mom that way. What about the crap that was your fault? Wait, let me guess. You fucked up time and space for your precious punk Chloe? You think she's worth all that? We all are. This isn't about Chloe, or even me anymore. Gosh, you're so selfless now, Mahatma Max. It's too bad you pissed your power away on high school drama. Chloe does a better job of guilt-tripping me than you do. Because you let her bully you. It's called Stockholm Syndrome. But you didn't do that homework, so you'll have to learn the hard way. Like Rachel. Just shut up. You're not scaring me anymore. I'd be more worried about Chloe killing us than Jefferson. Max, do you really think she's our friend? That she respects us in any way. Man, you are so stupid. I'm embarrassed to have the same name. And someday Chloe will destroy. Oh, hell, speak of the devil. Dude, do not even fuck with her head! She knows what we went through together this week, and you don't! There's no way you can break up our team! This is reality!
After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield.
I am seriously glad to see you.
Welcome home, Max. Fasten your seatbelt. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it. I know it was your birthday last month. Welcome home, Max. Fasten your seatbelt. This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, let's talk about your superpower. Epic! I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands. You can re- Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It's-
You saved me again! Crazy. Now we're totally bonded for life. Since you're the mysterious superhero,
I'm so glad you're my partner in crime.
As long as you're my partner in time. I might get on the other side of that door before you, Lupin. Max, you better come check out these files.
It's not a drawing. Look. Rachel in the dark room. Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it.
No, you are not taking the cozy chair.
Max, do your powers include mind reading? Or did you just rewind because I tried to steal the chair? Shit, I'm confused.
It's the powers of best friendship. I know how you roll.
Cowabunga! Why, look, an otter in my water. Your power has changed.
Let's call it a draw. I'm gonna freeze my ass off when I get out.
Yep, photobomb!
Photo hog. It feels like a different world from yesterday.
I double dare you. Kiss me now.
Sorry, not that easy.
Oh, like I am? Just admit that you already macked on me, then used your rewind. Now I can text Warren that you're saving yourself all for him.
You're such a dork.
Oh, we could cruise everywhere in this bad boy. Can you see us heading down the coast to Big Sur and beyond? I know. Just daydreaming. That makes me ill that Rachel posed like this for Frank. I wrote him love letters. I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
Because she knew how you would react.
And she wasn't much of a friend, huh? Just another person who shits all over me. Why does everybody in my life let me down? My dad gets killed, you bail on me for years, my mother gloms onto stepfucker, now Rachel betrays me. I double dare you. Kiss me now. Oh, we could cruise everywhere in this bad boy. Can you see us heading down the coast to Big Sur and beyond? I know. Just
not until I see it first. You know the rules, Dad.
Dude, I am so lucky that my father is cool. Max, you are being so fucking strange. You feel okay?
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
Oh, we could cruise everywhere in this bad boy. Can you see us heading down the coast to Big Sur and beyond? I know. Just it's weird hanging out with you again.
I know. I'm glad we are, though.
Look, the worst thing you can do... Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
Chloe, you're back.
I'm so glad you're here. Kate wasn't the first. All those binders are filled with other victims.
Rachel! Oh, Rachel, no, no, please not her!
Chloe.
Come on, Max, we're almost there.
We'll be okay. Max! Max, can you hear me? Please say something.
Chloe? I must have passed out.
Oh, thank God. Don't you ever do that again, okay?
I swear.
But that nightmare was so real. It was so horrible.
You didn't ask for it, and you saved me, which had to happen. All of this did, except for what happened to Rachel. But without your power, we wouldn't have found her. Okay, so you're not the goddamn Time Master, but you're Maxine Caulfield, and you're amazing. Max. This is the only way.
I feel like I took the shot 1,000 years ago.
You could use that photo to change everything right back to when you took that picture. All that would take is for me to
fuck that. No. No way! You are my number one priority now. You are all that matters to me.
I know. You prove that over and over again. Even though I don't deserve it. I'm so selfish. Not like my mom. Look what she had to give up and live through. And she did. She deserves so much more than to be killed by a storm in a fucking diner. Even my stepfather deserves her alive. There's so many more people in Arcadia Bay who should live. Way more than me.
Don't say that. I won't trade you.
You're not trading me. Maybe you've just been delaying my real destiny. Look at how many times I've almost died or actually died around you. Look at what's happened in Arcadia Bay ever since you first saved me. I know I've been selfish, but for once, I think I should accept my fate. Our fate,
Chloe.
Max, you finally came back to me this week, and you did nothing but show me your love and friendship. You made me smile and laugh like I haven't done in years. Wherever I end up after this, in whatever reality, all those moments between us were real, and they'll always be ours. No matter what you choose, I know you'll make the right decision.
Chloe, I can't make this choice.
No, Max. You're the only one who can.